Hi boys and girls, welcome back once again to the Connacht GAA Skills for Schools programme. I'm Derek Cox, a hurling coach in Sligo and Leitrim. Peter Callaghan is with us again, a hurler from Tremann and Roscommon. Peter has joined us once again very generously today to show us the skill of soloing in hurling and of course in camogie as well. Peter, talk to us a little bit about soloing.
Yeah, so we're going to demonstrate the single hand solo today. So dominant hand just below the grip or at the very end of the grip of the hurley, pointing down towards the boss, and then toe facing away, so as demonstrated here. And then we can do two approaches. We can just do the balance or the hop. And there are points.
Okay, excellent. When you say toe, of course, you mean the narrow part of the hurley?
The narrow part of the hurley that lifts the schlitter.
Facing away from us, and left-handers, of course.
Left-handers would be the opposite, right-handers would be pointed towards the right.
Excellent. Could you give us a quick demonstration?
Yeah, sure. So we're going to demonstrate the balance first. So.
Brilliant. And the hop solo too.
So then the hop solo just.
Excellent. Okay, so we're familiar enough with the soloing in hurling and camogie. We've seen plenty of examples of it, and indeed let's take a quick look now of some good examples of it in matches.
Eddie Brennan is there, so too is Brian O'Connell. The slither glued to the hurling. There's no evil stick required when you have skill like Brennan.
To it, Jerry O'Connor is available to help out. Here comes Charlotte O'Halpine. He's 45 metres out. O'Halpine has scored the last day. Looking for another one. And O'Halpine has got 2 points in two games.
Mind you, Cork and Limerick certainly produced it earlier. But many people thought that this was going to be the game of the day. Not skill, Eddie Brennan.
The solo run is a skill in hurling used to carry the ball to a better position from which to strike or pass the ball or to get away from an opponent. There are two variations of the solo run. The ball may be carried by balancing it on the hurley or by hopping it on the hurley. It is particularly important that young players are taught when to solo run and not to overuse the skill.
Got the hurling skill and the hurling know-how. Irrespective of whether you're champions or not, it's when you produce it out there.
He's come into the half-forward line. Pressure on here with Ben O'Connor. Ben shortening the grip on the stick and putting it over the bar. And
long time since he scored that goal. Into Lark Corbett. Bidding to add to his tally. He's got a support player. It's Kelly. If he tries to use him, it comes off. Corcoran looking for an outlet. It's Niall McCarthy. Kilkenny forcing him wide. Two men after him. Still he slips them. McCarthy looking to set up a goal for Cork. Ben O'Connor, he's got it!
DJ Carey, the Dodger himself. After him there was Ollie Baker. DJ steadying himself, turning it in beautifully.
All right, you've seen this in action now, and it's getting close to the time when you get to practice it yourself. We have three exercises for you to complete this week to try and improve your ability to solo the ball. Let's look at the first of the exercises.
This is a basic drill to practice the solo run technique. Divide the players into groups of five, one ball per group. Mark at a distance of 10 metres using cones. The players line up behind the first cone. Each player in turn solos out and around the far cone. On the return, they hand pass to the next player in line, who repeats the drill. Initially, players should catch the ball as they round the far cone. As they become more proficient, challenge them to round the cone without catching the ball. Placing two hands on the hurley may help the player control the ball until they are more comfortable with the technique.
Second one involves a little bit more movement. Let's take a quick look at the video.
This is an intermediate drill to practice the solo technique. Divide the players into groups of six, one ball per group. Mark out a triangle, placing the cones approximately 10 metres apart. Two players line up at each corner. Each player in turn solos out to the next cone, hand passing the ball to the next player from 2 to 3 metres away. Continue until each player is back in their original position. Repeat the drill going in the opposite direction. The ball should be passed using the right hand when moving in an anti-clockwise direction and with the left hand when moving in a clockwise direction.
And here is our third exercise for the solo, introducing a little bit of a game to us as well. Let's watch the video.
This is a modified game to develop the player's ability to solo run in a game situation. Mark out a playing area 40 metres long and 20 metres wide. Divide the players into two teams of five players. The aim of the game is to score by soloing with the ball over the opponent's end line. Players may only solo and hand pass the ball. The ball may be flicked off the hurley by an opponent, but no contact is allowed with the player or the hurley. If a ball is intercepted or falls to the ground, the other team gain possession.
Okay, so they are the exercises that you're going to get to do as soon as you head out to the yard or out to the grass. Important thing, of course, as always, is that you go and have a lot of fun in doing it. Myself and Peter, we'll talk to you again very soon.
Whenever you're ready.
Okay, boys and girls, welcome back inside. Myself and Peter have been practicing our solo running while you were gone as well, and I hope you get on well too and had a lot of fun. Remind us what the important things we learned today were.
Yeah, so the important things of a solo is your dominant hand at the end of the grip pointing towards the bossel of the hurl. So for right-handers, that's your right hand on the hurl. To keep your eye on the ball and the toe of the hurl to point away. So for the right-handers, to the right. For the left-handers, it'll be to the left.
Okay, excellent. Now, we do need to put a bit of a challenge on us as well, and I've challenged Peter to a little bit of a test here. We've three cones set out, a short distance between them, and we're going to try and run figure of eight in between them. I'm going to put 20 seconds on the clock for Peter and see how many cones he gets around inside those 20 seconds without the ball dropping. And then we're going to give you a chance to beat his score. Okay, Peter?
Yeah.
3, 2, 1, go. And stop. Excellent. So the good thing, Peter didn't drop the ball. He went around 13 cones individually. So that's the target now for you to beat inside that 20 seconds. Great thing about it is there's no limit to how many times you can try it. So keep going. And even if you can't quite get to Peter's score, you can keep trying to improve your own score. And maybe by next week, you will be besting this Roscommon man beside us. Thanks to Peter for coming and showing us the skills this afternoon. One other thing I want you to do just before we finish up, grab a little pen and pencil there. Write down two things that you really enjoyed about today's session, about the skills that you learned and what you were good at, and what you really enjoyed doing. And maybe one thing that you can work on yourself, whether that's practicing at home, practicing with your brothers or sisters, practicing with your neighbours or friends, or your classmates or clubmates. What do you think you can do a little bit better to get the most out of these new skills that we're learning all the time? So thanks again to Peter for joining us, and thanks to yourselves as well. We'll see you again soon.